In this lecture video, we are going to talk about open source development. So what is open source development? As the definition is already seen on the slide, open source development is an approach to software development in which the source code of the software system is published and volunteers are invited to participate in the development process. So open source development has its roots in Free Software Foundation, which advocates that source code should not be proprietary, but rather should always be available for users so that the users can examine and modify this source code as they wish. Now, open source software development extended this idea by using the internet to recruit a much larger population of volunteer developers. So these are some of the key features or usages of open source development. So many of these volunteers are actually the users of the code. In principle, at least, any contributor to an open source project can or may report and fix bugs, or he may propose new changes or new functionality. However, in practice, successful open source systems still will have or still will rely on a core group of developers who will control changes to the software. Now, the best known open source product, as we all know, is the Linux operating system. So this is widely used as a server system and increasingly as a desktop environment. Other important so open source products include Java, the Apache web server, MySQL DBMS, and so on. Another feature of open source software is that it's usually fairly cheap, or it's free to acquire. You can normally download an open source software without charge. However, if you want additional documentation and support, then you may have to pay for that. But again, the costs are fairly low. The other key benefits of using open source products is that the software will be mature and reliable. The reason for this is it has already been used and been tested by a large population of users who is willing to fix problems themselves rather than report these problems to the developer and wait for new releases for the system. So bugs are discovered and repaired more quickly than it is usually possible with proprietary software. Now, for a company involved in software development, there are two open source issues that they have to consider. First, should the product that is being developed make use of open source components, that is partly open source and partly licensed or proprietary components? Or should an open source approach be used for the software development? Here, should the software be completely open source? So if you're developing a software product for sale, then time to market and reduce costs are critical. So if you're developing in a domain in which there are high quality open sources already available, then you can save time and money by making use of these open source systems. However, if you are developing software for a specific set of organizational requirements, or something that needs to be customized, then using open source components may not be an option for you. You may have to integrate your software with existing systems that are incompatible with the available open source systems. Even then, however, it could be quicker and cheaper to modify these open source software systems so that they can communicate or interact and can be well integrated with the system you are going to develop. So publishing the open source code for a system, again, does not mean that people from the wider community will actually help you with the code development. Let's now talk about open source licensing. Although a fundamental principle of open source development is that the source code should be freely available, this does not mean that anyone can do as they wish with the code. Legally, the developer of the code, could be either a company or an individual, still owns the code. So they can place restrictions on how the code is being used by including legally binding conditions in an open source software license. Some open source developers believe that if an open source component is used to develop a new system, then even that new system should be open source. Other developers are willing to allow their code to be used to build restricted systems or licensed systems. Now, most open sources are derived from one of these three models. The first model is the GNU General Public License, abbreviated as GPL. So this is also called as the reciprocal license. It means that if you use open source software that is licensed under the GPL license, then you must make that software also open source. So to develop your software, if you're using an open source software and that open source software is licensed under GPL, then the new system you're developing also should be open source. The second general model is the GNU Lesser General Public License, or the LGPL. Now, this is a variant of the GPL license where you can write components that link to open source code without having to publish the source of these components. However, if you change the licensed component, then you must publish this as an open source. The third model is the Berkeley Standard Distribution License, or the BSD. So this is a non-reciprocal license, which means you are not obligated to republish any changes or modifications you make to the open source code. You can include the code in proprietary systems that are sold if you use open source components. However, you must acknowledge the original creator of the code, but you do not have any other restrictions or obligations more than the acknowledgement. If you're building a software that runs on an open source platform, say like Linux operating system, then licenses should not be a problem. However, as soon as you start including open source components in your software, you need to set up processes, databases, in order to keep track of what is being used and their licensing conditions and any other updates that you have made. So it is suggested that companies managing projects that use open source should follow the following guidelines or good practices. Firstly, establish a system for maintaining information about open source components that are downloaded and used. You have to keep a copy of the license for each component that was valid at the time the component was used. Licenses may change, so you need to know the conditions that you have agreed to. That is the first best practice. The second one is be aware of the different types of licenses and understand how a component is licensed before it is used. So here, you may decide to use a component in one system, but not in another, because you plan to use these systems in different ways. Thirdly, be aware of evolution pathways for components. You need to know a bit about the open source project where components were developed in order to understand how these components or how the code might change in the future. Fourthly, educate people about open source. It's not enough to have procedures in place to ensure compliance with licensing conditions. You should also educate developers about open source and open source licensing. Next, have an auditing system in place. So developers under tight deadlines might be tempted to break the terms of license. If possible, you should have a software in place to detect such things and stop them, because otherwise you may have legal implications. Lastly, participate in open source community. That is, if you rely on open source products or systems, then you should definitely participate in the community and help support their development and adding functionality, reporting bugs, or any other kind of improvement to the open source community. So the business model of software is changing. It's ever changing. It is becoming increasingly difficult to build a business by selling specialized software systems. Many companies still prefer to make their software open source and then sell support and consultancy to the software users. So this trend of using open source systems for developing new systems or new support systems is going to accelerate, or it's already accelerating. So it is important to learn, educate oneself and people about the open source licenses and contribute effectively to the open source community.